Would the chamber please come to order? We welcome our friends from across the Capitol building for this joint memorial service. Let's come to order, please. Appreciate you all being here. I appreciate Representative Stevens on behalf of the House Chair of the Memorial Service Committee, and Senator Kamak for their leadership, who's the Chair of the Senate Memorial Service. This is going to be a particularly poignant service for many of us because we do have a representative that we all were serving with that passed this last year. We welcome the members of the gallery here today. We appreciate the service that your loved ones have offered. I'm going to turn the program over to Representative Stevens.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Good afternoon, I'm Representative Mike Stevens. I want to thank all of you for attending this joint legislative memorial service. I want to give a special welcome to the family and friends of the legislators that we are honoring here today. You know, each year the legislature takes special time to honor every legislator that has passed away this prior year. You know, South Dakota's state pledge declares that South Dakota is a land of infinite variety. And clearly the statement is no more evident as we look at the legislators that we are honoring today and their backgrounds. You know, we honor Representative Irvin Bader, a rural mail carrier insurance adjuster born in Java, South Dakota, who was an original founder of the Webb Rural Water System. We honor Representative and Senator Roland Chiquin, who was a farmer, 4-H leader from rural Jefferson, who served in this legislature for 20 years and became the chairman of the South Dakota Water Congress. We honor Representative Dan Dryden, farm boy from Hot Springs who became the Rapid City School District business manager and who was instrumental in changing our state's school funding formula. Then there's Representative and Senator Jim Dunn, who started off as a machinist, heavy equipment, and diesel engine mechanic at Homestake Mining Company, and who served brilliantly for more than 30 years in this legislature. We have legislator Robert Duxbury, who received a college scholarship for livestock judging. He served 20 years in the legislature, and ultimately he became the South Dakota Secretary of Agriculture. And then there was Representative Elaine Elliott, who was a teacher born in Stickney, South Dakota, and she was one of the founders of South Dakota Reads Program. Representative Loudon Heller was from Ideal, South Dakota, and became a gunner on a B-24 airplane. And after the war, he started his teaching degree in Winter, South Dakota. We have Senator William Johnson, who's a graduate of Buffalo High School, and he became a rancher and a Harding County Commissioner, where he served for 16 years before serving in the South Dakota legislature. Then we have Senator Jacob Kroll, who grew up on a dairy farm south of Watertown, was commissioned second lieutenant in the Army, and served in the National Guard for 26 years, retiring as a Brigadier General. And then we have Senator Mary McClure Bibby, who was a graduate of Milbank High School. This legislator continued her education on a Fulbright scholarship, became a teacher in Redfield, became the first woman president pro tem in South Dakota legislature, and was ultimately named a special assistant to the president for intergovernmental affairs under President George H.W. Bush. Then we have Representative Glenn McVeigh, who was a farmer and was born in Harrisburg. He served his country in the Korean War and was awarded the Army Commendation Medal for meritorious service. Then there was Representative Dean Melhoff, who was a banker born in Eureka. He became the president of the South Dakota's Bankers Association and served as the chairman of the South Dakota Banking Commission. And then we have Representative William Myers, who was a farm boy, who grew up on the family farm in Cologne, who became an investment broker after he did his service in the Pacific in World War II. Representative Robert Rowe graduated from Hayti High School. After receiving his economics and political science degree, he ultimately worked as an independent financial consultant. Representative Bob Severson received the Purple Heart as a result of his service in World War II. This legislator served the Sioux Falls Fire Department for 27 years, retiring as captain. Senator Richard Waddell served as a gunner aboard a B-24 airplane, and after his service, he, his father, and brother bought a ranch north of Isabel, South Dakota, on Fire Steel Creek. You see, each legislator was unique and different in their own way. Truly, these individuals were legislators of infinite variety. Yet, even though each legislator was different in many ways, they were still the same. See, each was willing to take a risk and agree to run for office and maybe lose. Each was willing to donate their time for the benefit of others. And each was willing to face all of those hard decisions and take a stand in order, even if unpopular, to make our state a better place to live and to raise our families. As our good friend, former Senator Valley, would say, we all know here it's either yay or nay. There isn't a button for maybe. Maybe the biggest sacrifice these legislators made, however, was the precious time that they were required to be away from their spouses, children, and friends. My wife's father, Donnie Long, would say, Mike, you can always make more money, but you can't make more time. The most precious thing that any one of us has is our time. And if you want to know what is the most important thing in a person's life, you merely look at where they spend their time. You see, that time away from our spouses and children can never be replaced. You know, you think about missing that child's first step, or missing one of your children's first basketball games. And, well, there's a lot of firsts, aren't there? And you know, you don't get any mulligans for those. It's a sacrificial time that our families give us that is very precious. And hopefully, we spend that time that our families have given us to make wise decisions to make our state a better place. So, in addition to honoring these legislators today, we want to recognize the spouses, children, and friends of those special legislators for allowing their loved ones to do the work that needed to be done to make South Dakota a great place to live and raise our families. Besides your loved ones, we have also gathered in this great room, the People's House, to to also honor you as the sacrifices that you have made. Those of us who have been fortunate enough to have been elected and to have become servants of the people, we are building upon the foundation that your loved ones laid. Their dedication, their commitment, their sacrifice will not be forgotten. With this memorial service today, we also recognize you for your dedication, commitment, and sacrifice as well. At this time, I would like for all of the family and friends of those legislators that we are honoring today to stand to be recognized. Your loved ones could not have done this without you. You know, I think the greatest compliment anyone can receive at the end of their life is what is said in Matthew 25:23, where it says, "Well done, good and faithful servant." To each of you, I say, well done, good and faithful servant. On behalf of the state of South Dakota, we want to say thank you for the investment your loved ones and you have made for this to be a great state. At this time, I call upon Representative Julie Bartlane to lead us in prayer. Would everyone please stand?
Please bow your heads with me. Dear Lord, we come together today to honor our colleagues who have passed away over the past year. We gather to not only grieve the loss of these special friends, but to celebrate and give thanks for the lives while amongst us. We give thanks for the fullness of their lives that they shared with us and for their dedication to public service. We give thanks for their inspiration bestowed upon so many, and we especially give thanks for their friendship. We pray that you continue to give comfort to the families of our dear friends who now rest in the warmth of your arms and whom share in the glory of your kingdom. Lord, we ask that you remain with us as we gather to share fond memories of our friends, not only today, but always. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Please be seated. Good afternoon. My name is Representative Turbeville, and I'll be presenting the joint memorial resolution. Whereas the great ruler of the university has ordered a final adjournment in the lives of 16 former members of the South Dakota Legislature, namely the Honorable Roland Chiquin, the Honorable Dan Dryden, the Honorable James B. Jim Dunn, the Honorable Robert Duxbury, the Honorable Elaine Elliott, the Honorable Loden Heller, the Honorable William J. B. Johnson, the Honorable Jacob Jake Kroll, the Honorable Glenn McVeigh, the Honorable Dean O. Melhoff, the Honorable William Bill Myers, the Honorable Robert Bob Rowe, the Honorable Bob Sievertson, and the Honorable Richard Dick Waddell. And whereas in the lives of all these eminent public servants, there was a profound urgency in an unselfish manner, with trials and vicissitudes often far outweighing honors, but with a consciousness that here in a land of freedom, the dignity of the individual is supreme, that justice must be dispensed, that only by eternal vigilance and unrelenting effort can self-government of a people be preserved. And whereas it is fitting that we humbly honor the memory of those who have thus contributed to the orderly process of government, under the Constitution. Now, therefore, be it resolved by the Senate and the House of Representatives of the 92nd session of the legislature of the state of South Dakota, duly convened in recess session, in recognition of the useful lives and unfailing devotion to the interests of the state of South Dakota, as well as the rectitude of thought and action and fidelity to the highest principles of American citizenship by these honorable people, that the Senate and House representatives do now pause in their labors out of the respect for the memory of their late fellow associates in the functions of government, and note that in their passing, the state they have served so well has suffered a distinct loss, and though their labors have ceased and they have been laid to rest, the people of this great state have benefited greatly from the services rendered by them, and they have left upon the sands of time an inspiring record of devotion to their fellow citizens under the guiding hand of Almighty God. And be it further resolved that this resolution be printed in the journals of the Senate and the House of Representatives of the 92nd session of the legislature of the state of South Dakota, now assembled this 19th day of January 2017 at Pierce, South Dakota. Signed, Matt Michaels, President of the Senate, Kay Johnson, Secretary of the Senate, G. Mark Mickelson, Speaker of the House, Arlene Kavilson, Chief Clerk of the House. At this time, ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming Pier Riggs High School Chamber Choir, who will sing Earth Song.
Oh, please, dear, thy bows on me. Good afternoon. My name's Senator Gary Kamak, and I will be reading the names of our fellow legislators that have passed on before us in the placing of the rose ceremony. Irvin H. Bader, Edmonds County. Mr. Bader served as a state representative from 1955 to 1960. Roland A. Shequin, Union County. Mr. Shequin served in the House of Representatives from 1981 through 1986 and from 1993 through 2000, and in the State Senate from 1987 to 1992. Robert Danny Dan Dryden, Pennington County. Mr. Dryden represented District 34 in the House of Representatives from 2011 through 2016. James Bernard Jim Dunn, Lawrence County. Mr. Dunn served one term in the House of Representatives in 1971 through 72 and served in the Senate for 28 consecutive years, from 1973 through 2000. Robert Bob Duxbury, Hand County. Mr. Duxbury served the State Senate from 1981 and 1982 and from 1999 through 2004, and in the House of Representatives from 1985 through 1998. Elaine Elliott, Brown County. Ms. Elliott served in the State House of Representatives from 2009 through 2012. Loudon Heller, Tripp County. Mr. Heller served in the House of Representatives from 1957 through 1960. William J. Bill Johnson, Harding County. Mr. Johnson served as a state senator from 1987 through 1997. Jacob Jake Kroll, Cottington County. Mr. Kroll served in the state senate from 1973 to 1982. Mary McClure Bibby, Spink County. Ms. McClure Bibby served in the State Senate from 1975 to 1989. Glenn A. McVeigh, Lincoln County. Mr. McVeigh served one term in the State House of Representatives from 1985 through 1986. Dean O. Malhoff, McPherson County. Mr. McPherson served in the House of Representatives from 1967 through 1976. William Bill Myers, Tripp County. Mr. Myers served one term as a state representative from 1961 through 1962. Robert Bob Rowe, Brookings County. Mr. Rowe served in the House of Representatives from 1989 until 2000. Bob Dwayne Sievertson,
Minnehaha County. Mr. Sievertson served in the South Dakota House of Representatives from 1971 through 1976. Richard Dick Waddell, Dewey County. Mr. Waddell served in the State Senate from 1983 through 1990. We want to thank all of these individuals and their family for the service and sacrifice to the state of South Dakota.
Let us join our hearts together in a prayer of reflection. O God of grace and glory, we remember before you today our sisters and brothers who have served in the South Dakota State Legislature and have passed away this past year. We thank you for giving them to us as leaders and colleagues in the honorable work of tending to the care of the people and lands and resources of our state. Those of us who were close to these servants of yours, thank you for giving them to us to know and to love as companions on our pilgrimage here on earth. In your boundless compassion, console all who mourn their passing. Give us all faith to see in death the gate of eternal life, so that in quiet confidence we may continue our course on earth until by your call we are reunited with those who've gone before. Loving and gracious God, we ask that you would give rest to these your servants who are now with you in that place where sorrow and pain are no more. Into your hands, O merciful Lord, we commend these your servants. Acknowledge, we humbly beseech you, sheep of your own fold, lambs of your own flock, sinners of your own redeeming. Receive them into the arms of your mercy, into the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and into the glorious company of the saints in light. Amen. Well, we are glad to invite our choir back, the Pierre Riggs High School Chamber Choir. Thank you again for singing for us. Thank you.
We are always blessed to have the beautiful singing of the Riggs High School Chamber Choir at these memorials. Would you please join me in thanking them for their service and remain standing for the benediction? Almighty God and Heavenly Father, we are here this afternoon to remember. To remember 16 former legislators who have passed from our midst this previous year. Legislators who gave up time with their families, who gave up income, who gave up the luxury of being at home, to come to Pierre in the dead of winter to serve. To serve their districts, to serve the people of South Dakota, thereby serving you. It is with grateful hearts that we thank the families of these servants for all the sacrifices that they have made that allowed their loved ones to serve. May God wrap his loving arms around you and comfort you at this time. May the God of peace that passes all understanding guard your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus our Lord. And all the people said, Amen. Please remain seated for just some final thoughts.
Yes, please be seated. This is truly a special service for all of us, those of us that serve here in the legislature, the staff, everyone that's a part of this institution. We thank you for coming, especially to our family members of the loved ones that we are honoring today. We would like to extend a special offer to the families that please join us directly behind the rostrum here in the speaker's lobby. There will be some refreshments, coffee and cookies that our Capital Club spouses of the legislators have provided for you. If you're wondering on how to get there, just travel along the outer edges in the gallery to the stairway that's in the back of the chamber. Or if you should need the elevator, it's just off in the far corner there. Please ask that those that are here give priority to the family members to make their way down there. At the same time, all of us as legislators and staff, we should do our part if we can to go back there and meet the family members. So if you do have the available time, it certainly would be worthwhile. Again, we want to extend the most thank you as possible to the Riggs High School Chamber Choir and their director, Rod Bauk, and to the members, fellow members here of the Joint Select Committee, along with our staff at LRC who provided all of the information and contacted the families. With that, this concludes the 2016 Joint Memorial Service. You are dismissed, and thank you very much.